Welcome dear students, in this chapter first, that's some basic concepts of chemistry. In this part first, we will have a look on the introduction of chemistry, its development and various applications or importance of studying chemistry. So what is chemistry? Chemistry simply includes the three main things. One is the composition of matter, structure of matter and the properties of matter. Now what is matter? Matter is anything which has mass and has volume. So let's summarize. Chemistry is that branch of science which deals with the study of atoms, molecules and their transformation, or we can say branch of science which deals with the study of composition, structure and properties of matter. So chemistry got developed because of search of two interesting things. One is the philosopher's stone, which would convert all base metals like iron and copper into gold. Next is elixir of life, that substance which when drunk causes immortality. So let's have a look on the various importance of chemistry. Just you see the digestion process, digestion of food. There are various biochemical reactions taking place during the digestion process. Similarly, the medicine which we take, all these are organic compounds. And the fuel which runs various vehicles, they are nothing but the hydrocarbons. So this chemistry has a role in our daily life. Chemistry is interlinked with other branch of science like pharmaceutical, like forensics, environmental chemistry, biotechnology. So it is linked with various other branches of science. Now why study chemistry? With the knowledge of chemistry, we can identify the weather patterns. We can prepare the various fertilizers, alkalis, acids, salts, dyes and various other polymers. Chemistry has given us drugs, soaps, detergents, various metals, alloys, inorganic and organic chemicals which we use in our day-to-day life. Chemistry plays an important role in production of food, in the preparation of various healthcare products and other products. So with the knowledge of chemistry, we can produce superconducting ceramics, conducting polymers, optical fibers and miniature solid state devices. Just we are having silicon chip. Now with the knowledge of chemistry, we have synthesized safer alternatives for CFC, which have destroyed our ozone layer. These CFCs were used as refrigerants, but when they enter into the stratosphere, they destroy the ozone layer. Now, we have also understood use of enzymes for large-scale production of chemicals. Different exotic materials are synthesized in the laboratory nowadays. So let's summarize the importance of studying chemistry. Number first importance is in the food industry, that supply of food. Chemistry has given us various fertilizers, insecticides and pesticides, similarly food preservatives and the various methods to check food adulteration. Second is health and sanitation. So nowadays dreadful diseases are treatable with the help of medicines and drugs like cisplatin and Taxol for cancer, azidothymidine for AIDS. Similarly, application in industry. Chemistry has given us large number of products like glass, cement, paper, textiles, leather. So chemistry has helped in the sense of new materials having specific magnetic, electrical and optical properties. Next application is in saving our environment. Chemistry has given us eco-friendly refrigerants which have replaced CFCs. Similarly, CNG very effective in checking pollution. Similarly, biodegradable polymers. Similarly, chemistry has made our life highly comfortable, pleasurous and luxurious by giving synthetic fibers like terracotta, terry wool, terry slick. Similarly, building materials. Similarly, various metals and articles of domestic use like soaps, detergents, cosmetics, perfumes. All these are organic compounds. Similarly, in entertainment, we are using celluloid as a photographic film. Another application is in transport and communication. All types of vehicles run on fuels like petrol, diesel, CNG. All these are hydrocarbons. Hydrogen is used as a rocket fuel because of its very high calorific value. Similarly, mobile phones are using batteries which use acids. Similarly, semiconductors like silicon chips. Another application is in war. Gases like mustard gas, phosgene, tear gas, highly poisonous in nature. Explosives like TNT, trinitrotoluene, nitroglycerine, dynamite, atom bomb and hydrogen bomb, which run on nuclear fission and nuclear fusion reaction. Similarly, nuclear energy. Chemistry has given an alternative source of electricity, that is the nuclear energy. In nuclear reactors, there is nuclear fission responsible for that. So hope that you have understood the various applications of studying chemistry. Thank you for watching.